Dawn of the Dead. When there is no more room in hell, the dead will walk with the earth. George Romero's Night of the Living Dead in 1968 is a low-budget classic. He engaged race relations in the 1960s at an almost documentary level. There is no disputing that. 10 years later, his second zombie feature, Dawn of the Dead, continued Romero's trend of refracting collective issues in the most unexpected of places. The film has all the elements crucial to effective storytelling. Great atmosphere, sympathetic characters, and the urgent pacing. It is this delicate crafting that allows some people to transcend mere horror. Within the vessel of the disturbing living dead, Romero here explores the uncanny relationship between the zombies and the culture of capitalism, setting his flesh-eating horror in, of all places, a suburban shopping mall. 4 SWAT team members escape in a helicopter. They come across a deserted suburban Philadelphia shopping mall and break in through the roof. After fighting the zombies, they manage to secure the mall and stock up on all supplies until they find themselves besieged by a motorcycle gang who would rather kill them in order to loot the mall than band together against the zombies and living out the American dream. Dawn of the Dead provides a cunning critique of the American consumer, arms outstretched, feet shuffling to the mellow pop-up music. The zombies wander stupidly around the mall, with only most basic need for survival. Beyond these automatons, however, the mall's 4 human inhabitants add a complexity to the Romero's assessment of capitalism. Spending months there, the survivors convert their storage area into a plush apartment, taking all they need and want. Nevertheless, the omnipresent views of the cavernous and deserted mall are the constant reminder that this excess of consumerism is only a distraction from the danger that exists just beyond the door. Danger born from own violence. Romero's horror films have an enduring and eerie quality, perpetually jarring us from the fantasy of graphic zombie horror to remind us that real life is just as frightening. The mortal concern of Dawn of the Dead unsettles us even after the living dead are left behind. The moral heart of the film, for me, is the best represented by an old priest who surprised 2 of the characters in a tenement basement. When the dead walk, we must stop the killing or we lose the war. In the film is also gloriously, delightfully excessive. Horror makeup and facial effects master Tam Savini splatters his mark all over this one. The film is actually so violent and gruesome that it was released unrated in the United States for fear of being slapped with an X rating. Dawn of the Dead was a collaboration made in horror heaven. Italian horror maestro Dario Argento helped secure funding for the film in exchange for the right to oversee the international cut of the film. Dario Argento also served as an uncredited writer and helped the score using his band The Goblins. But ultimately, it's George Romero's direction that makes this film a classic. The location for much of the action was Mornoville Mall, at the time one of the largest malls in the US.